بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه الطيبين. All praise is due to Allah, and we ask Allah Ta'ala to raise the rank of our Prophet Muhammad and to protect his nation from that which he fears for them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us high ranks in the Akhirah, to save us from the torture of the grave and the torture of the hereafter. Brothers and sisters, inshallah, tonight I will be talking about one of the miracles of Prophet Isa alayhi salam. Prophet Isa alayhi salam, named in English as Prophet Jesus alayhi salam, is the second last prophet. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the last of the prophets. The period of time between Prophet Isa and Prophet Muhammad is about 600 years, close to 600 years. And there was no other prophet between Prophet Isa and Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Prophet Isa, the second last, and Prophet Muhammad is the last. Allah Ta'ala sent many prophets, not only Prophet Isa and Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, sent many prophets to teach and spread the religion of Islam, which is the true religion and the religion of all the prophets and messengers, starting from Prophet Adam alayhi salam and ending with Prophet Muhammad. They all came with one religion, which is Al-Islam. Allah Ta'ala supported each of his prophets with many miracles, mu'jizat, supernatural matters that indicate their truthfulness, that they are sent from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as prophets and messengers. Among the miracles of Prophet Isa alayhi salam was the table banquet of Prophet Isa alayhi salam. And there is a surah in the Holy Quran called Surah Al-Ma'idah. Prophet Isa alayhi salam ordered Al-Hawariyin, who were the best of the people who believed in him. They are his elite students, Al-Hawariyun, and in specific, there were about 12 of them called Al-Hawariyun, the elite of these group of people called Al-Hawariyun. He ordered Al-Hawariyin to fast 30 days. They used to fast the same way as we do, refraining from eating, drinking, and other invalidators. He ordered them to fast 30 days in paying thankfulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were in the desert upon the completion of 30 days. So they completed 30 days, they fasted 30 days in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Prophet Isa alayhi salam traveled, he would be followed by thousands of people. Some were his companions, Al-Hawariyun, some were sick or had sicknesses and wanted Prophet Isa alayhi salam to supplicate Allah Ta'ala to cure them. He was famous that he used to make dua for the sick people, and they used to be cured by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was famous to be of that miracle, curing the sick people and even the blind people and people inflicted with leprosy and other diseases. The Hawariyun asked Prophet Isa alayhi salam if they could have a banquet descend for them from the skies. They knew that Prophet Isa alayhi salam was supported with miracles, and they asked him for this mu'jiza. They wanted to be assured that Allah Ta'ala accepted their fasting. Prophet Isa alayhi salam was fearful for them from this request and warned them that they might not thank Allah Azza wa Jal properly if He gave them this endowment. So He reminded them to be thankful to Allah Azza wa Jal when Allah Ta'ala bestows upon them this mu'jiza. Prophet Isa alayhi salam went where he usually prayed, the place where he usually prays, and he put on a cloth made of wool, and he made a dua, supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that their request would be answered. He asked Allah Ta'ala for them, for this table, ma'ida. Allah Ta'ala accepted the dua, supplication of Prophet Isa alayhi salam, and a banquet descended from the skies by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The banquet settled near Prophet Isa alayhi salam, landed near Prophet Isa alayhi salam, and it was covered with a cloth. Prophet Isa alayhi salam took the cloth off while saying, Bismillah khayrir raziqin, which means, in the name of Allah, the best sustainer, subhanahu wa ta'ala. There was 7 big fish, 7 loaves of bread, vinegar, salt, pomegranate, which is a type of fruit, honey, fruits, and a wonderful smell that no one had ever smelt before. It was a mu'jiza, one of the miracles of Prophet Isa alayhi salam. The news of the feast reached the non-believers, and they came to see this unusual and extraordinary occurrence. They did not hear about it before, and they have not seen anything like it. So they came to see what's going on. Prophet Isa alayhi salam ordered the poor people first, and especially those with illnesses or diseases, the handicapped, the blind, the deaf, the mute, and so on, to eat from it first. There was close to 1,300 of them, more than 1,000 of them, all came and ate from it, and they were cured by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The blessings from this great miracle of the banquet was all those that ate from it, whether they were handicapped or had a sickness, were all cured by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Furthermore, the ones who were poor became rich. Not only they were satisfied by eating from it, and they became rich if they were poor. It was mentioned that every day they used to eat from it 7,000 people. Imagine, 7,000 people every day they used to eat from it. And there were plenty of fish, plenty of pomegranate, fruits, and the like. So they ate from it, and it would return back to normal by the will of Allah, so that another 7,000 used to eat from it, and so on, day after day. 40 days after the banquet had been among them, imagine every day 7,000 multiplied by 40 days. So a huge number of them ate from it, and they became cured, and those who were poor became rich by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After 40 days, Allah ta'ala revealed to Prophet Isa alayhi salam to only allow the poor people to eat from it and not the rich, not anymore. Those who ate from it, that's it. Otherwise, the rich are not allowed to eat from it anymore. He also ordered the poor people to eat from it only and not to take away with them any food. Just eat from it and go. Don't take anything with you home. It was a little bit difficult for them to obey the orders of Prophet Isa alayhi salam, whom Allah Ta'ala had revealed to Prophet Isa alayhi salam. So they were ordered to eat from it, to thank Allah Azza wa Jal, and not to take food with them home. The hypocrites, which are called al-munafiqun, those who claimed that they are Muslims, but in fact they did not believe in Allah Azza wa Jal. In their hearts, they did not believe in Allah. However, they claimed that they are Muslims. When they heard about the Ma'ida of Prophet Isa alayhi salam and what had happened, they used to take this as an excuse to shed doubt about Prophet Isa alayhi salam, to attack him alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah Ta'ala revealed to Prophet Isa alayhi salam what means, "I will torture those who blaspheme." Allah revealed to his Prophet Isa alayhi salam that he is going to torture those who blasphemed, who did not believe in Allah, did not believe in Prophet Isa as a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The following day, 33 people woke up to see that they had been transformed into pigs. They were humans and they were transformed into pigs. Wal-iyadhu billah. It was a punishment for them. However, those who were transformed into pigs did not have any descendants. They only remained for 3 days, after which they died. Not only those during the time of Prophet Isa who were transformed into pigs, some other times as well, as Allah Ta'ala mentioned in the Holy Quran, that other people as well, such as the people of Prophet David, Dawood alayhi salam, they were transformed as well into pigs and apes. Wal-iyadhu billah. They remained for number of days, after which they passed away, they died. Those who were transformed into pigs came to Prophet Isa alayhi salam crying in shame. And the Prophet alayhi salam said to them, "Aren't you that person?" He used to address them. He knew them. And each would shake his head, but unable to speak. And they died as such. It was a punishment for those who did not adhere to the teachings of Prophet Isa alayhi salam. They disobeyed his orders, and they were transformed into pigs as a type of punishment. Prophet Isa alayhi salam had many miracles, not only this, had many of them. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to give us the strength and the power to do more acts of obedience, inshaAllah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and Allah Ta'ala knows best.